That'd be the introduction to biology. So basically, this chapter is a very basic chapter. And basically, this chapter is introducing what is biology is all about, what is study of biology is, definition of biology. If you studied biology, how you can apply it in your further career level when you enter into your universities, into your job. And in this chapter is basically giving you some of the important aspect of scientific investigation, scientific skills that a biology student, a biologist should have. So we're going to see straightforward to the concept map. So in this introduction to biology, basically biology referring to the study of living things. So whatever that is living around us, be it an animal, a plant, okay, human like us, we are all living things, including something that we can't see around us, which is including the microorganism, like bacteria, viruses, fungus, all the parasites around us. So these are all referring to the study of biology. So the importance of biology is basically, we're going to see that how biology, how the system around us, how the plant, how the animal, and how all things that is living are interacting with one another, how we are interdependent, be it a living thing or non-living thing. So all of these come to a concept of biology. So next, we're going to see what is the different study of biology. So it's an easy example. We can classify in the sense of studying plant as botany. Studying of animal can be zoology. Study of microorganism can be microbiology. And there are a lot of studies that basically give you rise to this kind of thing. So there are different studies. We're going to study with biochemistry level. There's immunology, studying of immune system. And there are other studies as well, which you can refer in the textbook. And the later part is career related to biology. Is basically those who have studied biology are basically can use this concept and apply it. And his example we can see is career related to medicine. If you want to be a doctor, you can basically need to have a strong foundation of biology. Research also required a biology background. Working in laboratory as a technician required a biology background. And this is not limited to that. There are also other branches of careers that is requiring biology as a part of the part of this career. Okay, so in the next part is we're going to appreciate few of the scientific skills or scientific method that is important in biology. Not only biology, in all the scientific skills, be it the chemistry, be it the physics, all require this study. So first is we need to identify a problem. So a problem is basically where in a certain investigation where a problem is basically we're going to see that certain situation happen and certain experiment have a problem. By identifying a problem, a root cause of those scientific things, we need to make a hypothesis, which is basically referring to making a prediction, making an inference. If something happened, this is what caused it. And if we increase certain things, we predict this is going to be the outcome is. So next is planning of experiments important in biology or all in the scientific field. We need to know that what we want to do, what items, what apparatus, what equipment are required, what material, be it the raw material, are required for the study. And we're going to have to do some controlling of variable. In this sense, the most commonly control variables are manipulated variables that change according to the problem and what we want to investigate, and followed by the responding variables that is actually respond towards the manipulated variable. And this is followed by the constant variable or fixed variable, where you can see that when you want to do an experiment, a certain condition need to be fixed, need to make constant so that we know that these factors are not affecting. These are made to be fixed. And the later part is conducting experiment. Obviously, we need to make sure that the experiment is conducted to prove the hypothesis and find a solution for the problem. Data usually collected, and we have to usually analyze, interpret the data. Data need to be tabulated, analyzed later using a graph, using any appropriate graphical method, so that we can actually see it rather than looking at the table, because most of it values in a number. So graph will give a better idea of a trend, a certain changes in the trend most of the time. And finally, we are going to make a conclusion, because conclusion will say whether the hypothesis is being accepted or not to accept. If it's not accepted, then we have to make sure that these our predictions are quite wrong, and we have to know that the problem is caused by other things. And finally, we have to make sure the investigation are reported, make sure the investigation are being actually reported to others. So we need to write a good report which covering the problem hypothesis, the procedure, the variable, the results, and the other interpreting value, and finally make a conclusion. So this give rise to the end of the first chapter. Usually first chapter is a basic chapter, and most of the time question is very rare to be asked, because you will be using these scientific methods for SPM students will be in your paper 3.